Bar she blows. Having a whale of a time. That's what it said. Right there. There's proof. They basically called her a whale. I definitely should have dressed up as a pirate for this. Dang it. Lost opportunity. But I do have a green screen. There she blows! You see the drippy, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car in a giddy up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. This video is sponsored by me. If you're interested in my super fun, meme sharing, pretty nerdy, but also cool weight loss support group that comes with a variety of workout programs, click the link below. We would love to have you. Hello, welcome back to the channel, but if you're new, welcome. My name is Michelle McDaniel. I'm a personal trainer. A proud mother of a pup. And a chihuahua. A past theater nerd gone a grown-up cosplayer, and this is my channel. My thoughts will probably offend you where I share my thoughts, though will probably offend at least one person. Because whenever you share your opinion online, someone's gonna take it personally and write you a whole paragraph telling you that you're wrong and that you need to change your opinion so that it matches their opinion, so they feel better about their opinion. So don't be shy, let us know what you're offended about today in the comment section. This is the place to do it, and while you're down there, you might as well hit the subscribe button because I post 1 to 3 times a week and sometimes dressed in cosplay. Ah, the National Enquirer, probably the best, most legit, prestigious, well-researched, and well-versed magazine that has ever hit the checkout line shelves in the grocery store. And by that, I mean funniest, shittiest, most rude magazine I've ever read. It kind of musters up a lot of emotions in me, as you can see. And I never buy magazines anymore, but mama bought this one. Recently, the National Enquirer put out this beauty. This year's 50 best and worst beach bodies. The good, the bad, and the ugly. Mama June, fat. Kate Hudson, I guess she doesn't have a super flat stomach. Disgusting. Rob Lowe, I have no clue if this is good to them or bad to them. I've never read this magazine before. I don't even know who Rob Lowe is. Oh, he's the Atkins commercial guy.
You know the saying, life is uncertain, have dessert first? Must be the thinking behind the new Atkins dessert bars.
And he used to look like this. Okay, so bad. Guess who? I'm not gonna guess who, but I'm gonna guess that they're saying that she's too skinny. J-Lo. We all know that she got best body because even if she didn't have the best body, she would straight up shank anyone that insulted her body, said that she used any kind of fillers or got plastic surgery. So National Enquirer knows exactly what to do with J-Lo. Praise her. Gerard Dupree, not saying that word, but I see a lot of good just flopping over. And guess what? Our girl, Tess Holliday, was voted one of this year's worst beach bodies. And she was livid. So YouTube, I present to you this year's 50 best and worst beach bodies. The good, the bad, and the ugly, according to the National Enquirer. Get your popcorn. It's gonna get pretty bad. All right, let's see. Jennifer Aniston. Okay, this isn't really fair. This is like taking a picture of me minding my own business on the beach, trying to relax. I have endometriosis, for anyone that doesn't know. Part of that means I get very bloated to the point where if I go out in public, people literally have rubbed my stomach and said, "Oh my gosh, you're glowing. You're gonna be so happy once you embrace your little bundle of joy after it rips your vagina open." Except I'm just bleeding out of my... So that's like taking me when I'm in that state, plopping me on the beach, I'm trying to relax, not think about the very painful cramps that I have, and let my stomach just hang out. And then some clump nugget of a photographer is like, "Hey, this seems like the perfect time to take a picture, because she probably feels like shit right now." And then they send it to the National Enquirer. Jerk, she doesn't even look fat. She looks like she just ate a meal, or she's just relaxed, and not forcibly sucking in her stomach. But let's see what it says. Sitcom sweetheart Jennifer Aniston, 52, is nearly always picture perfect, but in this shot, the former Friends, I mean, that's pretty much all Jennifer Aniston has ever done. Just being the sitcom sweetheart in Friends. That's it. Nothing else. Friend star looks down in the dumps and kind of dumpy, like she downed too many burritos. Yeah, that's how my stomach would look if I downed too many burritos. Kate Hudson, mommy has a tummy.
Kate Hudson, a mother of three, can't hide her pouchy stomach in a pink bikini. The rom-com cutie, 43, could use some tightening up. This is another one. Not fair. They decided to take the worst angle. They got an action shot of Kate. I don't know what the hell she's doing, but she's doing something in motion. She's definitely not fat, and to me, not too thin. If you go over to Janice Dickinson, who was also voted worst beach body, she does look super thin, a lot of muscle atrophy, which means a lot of muscle loss, especially as you get older. It's very important to lift weights so then you don't have a lot of muscle atrophy and you can avoid all the very important, not fun things that happen when you lose a lot of muscle as you age. That's why lifting weights is very important. Janice Dickinson, what an eyesore. Former supermodel Janice Dickinson, 66, exposed loads of wrinkly skin. Oh, they're not even getting on her for being like very thick. They're getting on her because she has wrinkles? And then they zoomed into her little old arm? Damn! The puckered epidermis of her belly, arms, and legs looked like it was plucked from a chicken. What? I'm gonna give that diss a 2 out of 10. I don't know what that means. Maybe someone can explain. Katie Holmes, former Dawson's Creek cutie. Katie Holmes is a regular Rip Van Winkle. Looks like the 42-year-old ex-wife of Tom Cruise. What does that have to do with anything? What does her being the ex-wife of Tom Cruise has to do with anything? Has a few things to iron out in her midsection. Oh my god. Who in the world is writing this? Once again, they pick a very horrible angle. She's leaning over, curving her spine so then all her skin goes forward. It's very simple to think about. If you crunch over like that, your skin is going to fold. No shit, she's gonna have some wrinkles and fold. She's not an anime character. Is that what you think women are supposed to look like? Anime characters where they have ginormous watermelon boobs, super tiny waist, and when they lean over, their skin is just pristine and tight? You've got something wrong with you if your skin doesn't fold when you fold over. You're a mannequin.
Chet. This is a mannequin.
Back when Nadine and I got married, I was a mannequin too.
Oh, Mama June. They got her feet all dirsty. Dusty and dirty, it's my new word that you are allowed to use. I'm such a nice person. Use it however you want. Thirsty. Mama June's feet. It fits Mama June very well. I have an upcoming video on her. She is a mess. But let's see what the National Enquirer had to say. Reality wreck Mama June. Yeah, I mean, accurate. Reality wreck Mama June, 41, is a sight for sore eyes as she pushes her weight around. Dr. Gabe Merkin estimated the 5'4" oddball carries an astonishing 256 pounds. Looks like the From Not to Hot star. Is not. This was not as harsh as the other one. Maybe because Mama June is a public train wreck. The drugs, the sketty. So you're probably saying, well, where the hell are all the men? Are they just gonna critique women? Nope. They've got men in here. Will Smith, I'm in the worst shape of my life, said Will Smith as he displayed his gut. Once known for his physique, he's blown up into the flesh prince of Bel-Air. Ooh. Good one. Robin Thicke, gutsy, doesn't even try to hide his saggy belly with a pair of low-slung board shorts. Sit-ups would tighten the father of four's droopy dad bod. Actually, it wouldn't be sit-ups. It would just be calorie deficit, some cardio, and probably just overall lifting weights and compound movements. What a day when I can't trust the National Enquirer to give me fitness tips. Ugh, the world we live in. Steve Harvey. Was Steve Harvey ever like a body icon? He just seems like one of those uncles at a cookout with the gut that gives relationship advice to everyone, but is also cheating on his wife. So, I don't think he cares what he looks like. Leonardo DiCaprio? Blobby. Blobby Leonardo DiCaprio, 46, looks like he can definitely float if the Titanic sinks again. The Oscar winner needs to make sure he doesn't turn into the, hold on. The great Fatsby. Oh my god, that was good. Ah yes, the best bodies, what everyone wishes they were, you know. Think back in high school when there were the popular people that you wanted dearly to hang out with, to just smell them. And maybe some of their sweet, awesome looks will rub off on you. Well, this is them. Except they are insanely rich as well. J-Lo, Juliana Hodges, Brooke Shields, Courtney Cox, Suzanne Lucci, 74. 74? Damn! She deserves to be on this list. She looks good. You know, the funny thing is though, if they took any of these women and sat them in the same position as Jennifer Aniston or Kate Huddleston, they would have ended up on the worst bodies list. Because I can pretty much tell and I looked very, very hard to make sure I'm 100% certain that they are not anime characters. So their skin does in fact move and fold. I'm sorry, but very out of myself that I figured that out first before everyone else. Spread the word. Okay, I was wrong about Rob Lowe. They absolutely love his body. Ageless Rob Lowe is rocking his Brad Pitt bod. A little bit different, but okay. The 57-year-old Parks and Recreation star who has followed a low-carb diet for decades looks as beachy keen as he did in the 80s. No, he doesn't. The magazine seems to be very, very critical. And the more that I read, they seem to be playing favorite and not being as hard on some people as they were on just like other people. It's very confusing because he does have a very soft midsection. If they got a side profile, made sure that he just ate and drank and then leaned over, he would look a lot bigger and his stomach would also hang a bit. Just as a personal trainer, I can tell. And remember when I said they seem to be like playing favorites? They have Andy Cohen in here. And keep in mind, I'm being critical because this magazine is very critical. So I'm not saying that these bodies are bad. I'm saying they seem to go hard on certain imperfections, and his body is clearly not perfect. But look at what they say. Look who's been going to the gym. Real Housewives executive producer Andy Cohen, 53, emerges from the deep with his toned torso on display. What? Me, National Enquirer. No, don't. I know what this is. You're playing with my head. He is clearly not chiseled. You can tell he's got quite a bit of lower abdominal fat. Very similar to the other guys that I saw where they got side profiles of, which makes it look more apparent. This one is from the front, and so it doesn't look as chunky. Angles, people. All about those angles. So Lizzo is in here. Songstress Lizzo is living large and proud of it. Every inch of the 33-year-old Truth Hurts singer jiggles and folds, spilling out of her itsy bitsy bikini. At 350 pounds, that's a whole lot of flesh. Why do they have this woman in here? Who is Duchess Camila? I don't know who that is, but she's 74 years old. Do you have a 74-year-old woman here just trying to take a walk on the beach, trying to just live? And they got this to say. Meet the Duchess of Midriff Bulge. The 74-year-old wife of Prince Charles, Duchess Camila, is a royal wreck in a drab suit that struggles to contain her thick midsection, flabby thighs, and droopy boobs. How dare a 74-year-old woman have droopy boobs? Hey, Duchess, get the plastic surgery, okay? So then people can make fun of you for being a 74-year-old woman with boobs that go all the way up to your face. Because you know they will. Teresa Guida, Wendy Williams. I mean, I'm not the most body positive person. You know, I like to critique things and make fun of things. She's gotten a lot of surgeries, and when you get so many surgeries, it makes your body look a little cartoonish, and she looks very cartoonish. And I personally think she deserves to be on this list. Wendy Williams will say anything about anyone's physique. She ain't body positive. She loves talking about people's physical appearance. Tara Reid, lumpy Tara Reid, 45, is not in the pink, despite her brightly colored bikini top. The American Pie actress has been vocal about hating the results of her beauty interventions that left her boobs saggy and tummy protruding. Yeah, let's point out what she hates, even though she's been vocal about hating what you pointed out. Good job. Just shove the knife in her heart a little bit more and then twist it around. Ooh! Okay. Oh, he's from the front. He was the guy that was leaning over with the gut. Gerard Depruit. We're not even gonna try that name. French fatty Gerard, 72, looks more like a beached whale than an award-winning actor. With that gigantic gut, the 340-pound star would sink like a stone if he got in the water. Okay, well, there you have it. They do not discriminate because they called this man a whale, and they also called Tess Holliday a whale. Tess Holliday, there she blows, doesn't shy away from having a whale of a time at the beach. But Dr. Stuart Fisher believes the model is clocking in at 305 pounds. And she gave the National Enquirer her attention and gave them a piece of her mind on her Instagram. LOL, I was voted the worst beach body this year, and it makes me mad. Because it's 2021 and we are all still publishing trash like this, corny, but also makes me laugh because I'm hot as fuck. I mean, I have my certain opinions about this magazine too, but I also feel that people that believe that they are hot as fuck don't have to constantly tell other people that they're hot as fuck. They are just hot. They just do their thing. They show their butt. They shake their tits. They just do their own little hot thing without telling everybody that they're hot. But anyway, they used a photo from last year, and I included some more recent photos, keep swiping, of me last month looking fine as hell in a string bikini so they can have the most updated not hot content. Also, I was hot last year too. The media always acts shocked when celebs suffer from mental health breakdowns, but they continue to perpetuate unrealistic body standards and push toxic diet culture on us all. If you are seeing this and you're fat as hell or just have a body that isn't chiseled and traditionally hot and want to go to the motherfucking beach or put on a swimsuit, do it. You only get one life and we are making the most of it, baby. I mean, she continuously disregards that she will live a way better quality of life if she was at a smaller weight and ate healthier foods and stopped binging. That would literally help you make the most of the one life that you live, but whatever. I know this group picks and chooses, so. But the blatant ignorance of the very positive aspects of being a healthy weight and eating healthy food, I very much agree with Tess Holliday. Oh my gosh, girl, are we best friends now? No. But I guess my final question is, who the fuck writes this? So me and my team started searching for weeks, tons of late nights, lots of coffee and treats. We were frustrated, tired. We started turning on each other until Yoshi found a breakthrough in the case. She asked who was always stirring up drama, who likes to report on drama, who was featured in the magazine for a body that would have probably ended up on the worst beach body list. That's right, Andy Cohen. Yoshi always solves the case. Here's a treat, girl. And she's 100% right in this because I couldn't find any names that write for that section. They obviously want to stay hidden for a very apparent reason. So I'm just gonna go with Yoshi's theory. She never let me down before. Anyway, if you are upset about this magazine or whoever wrote it, they are literally trying to get a reaction. That's why they say the most ridiculously hurtful things. It's basically some troll trying to get the celebrity's attention. And Tess Holliday took the bait just like a whale. Ooh, poor taste? I don't know. But it was in the article, so I fitted it. Okay, guys, well, this is the end of the video. I'll miss you, but you know what? You don't have to miss me or my dog. You can go right now and watch every single video at least minimum 3 times each. And then after you're done with all of that, you can go to my Instagram and just like all my pictures. And then tell my dogs that they are adorable and then kiss the screen. Just kiss it. Clean it off first. Phones are quite dirty. And then kiss your screen after it's clean. Okay? Team, ready? Hands in. 1, 2, 3. Watch all my videos. Remember, you do not have to be a size 2. Having big biceps is great, but not needed to be healthy. And these little comments in the magazine are pretty stupid. So just remember that, okay? I'll see you guys next time. Watch my videos. Okay, bye. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. You see the drip, yeah, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car and I get it up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. You see the drip, yeah, I'm fitted up. Hop in my car and I get it up. Secure the bag, yeah, I get the bus. Pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. Ooh, I've been on the flex since flex zone. Neighborhood all in your eardrum.